Okay, so welcome back. In this class, we're going to look at paragraph formatting in WPS. So assuming we have this document, okay, that we've just copied and pasted this document from somewhere, and we are trying to play around with the paragraphing issues, okay? So you can see up here, we have the paragraphing issues, okay? Everything is at the home tab. You have the option to play around with the numbering, which is the first one. You can see we have different kind of bulleting, okay? Different kind of bullets. You can increase, you can insert bullets of different types. You can see different kind of bullets. So assuming we want to insert for this very simple list of text, you can come over here, select them, and come over here and put this kind of bullet format. You can see the formatting, or you can change it to this type if you are interested. Or you can change it to this tick type if you're interested, depending on the kind of bullet you are interested in. Or you can come over here and set numbering. You can have different kind of numbers, 1, 2, 3, just like so, or 1, 2, 3 separated by different kind of bracket. So you can use this. You can see it has just separate them. Or you can have 1, 2, 3 in Roman numerals of different types, small letters, you can see. Or you can have 1, 2, 3, but then of ABC, just like so. You can have them in ABC format, and you can have them in ABC separated by brackets as well. So it all boils down to you how you want it, for example. So this is the first one, assigning bullets and numbers to any list, okay? So you can select any text, and you can do all sort of alignments from here. You can align left. Right now, everything is aligned left. You can see it at default. You can align right. If you click, you can see it has been aligned right. Everything now is centered to right. Or you can align align center. So this align center, this is align right, and everything is now centered, is now at the straight line from the right angle. You can see it over here. Or you can do justification by just clicking here, and it's going to readjust everything to fill up the edges. Okay, you can see it professionally done. Or you can extend to fill up everything. You can stretch around to make everything fill up, to stretch the text or the wordings around, so it's just filled up the entire thing. Okay, so you can see everything is now fixed to at both ends. Or you can play around with this line spacing by just clicking on this. You can, this is the default, is at 1.0, which is single line spacing. You can make it 1.5, and you can see the spacing, the vertical spacing in between the lines have increased. In cases, in some cases when you are writing project or thesis, you may require to go to double line spacing, and that's when you come to 2.0, and you can see the spacing has actually increased to 2.0 across different kind of lines. So this is the feature that you're going to use to increase or decrease the line spacing as you so wish. So for now, I'm going to keep it at 1.5. And over here at the top, you can play around with the indenting. Right now, you can press this one to increase the indenting, which means to move inwards from the main bar or main end. You can move the paragraph inside. You can keep moving inside if you want. You can see you can keep increasing the indenting, or you can reduce it by using this feature to reduce the indenting, and you're back to where you started. So it all depends on what kind of writing or what kind of criteria you are using in your write-up, and you can be able to do that and adjust accordingly. Next, we have the character scaling. Okay, this one, you have the character scaling. You can combine characters, everything in one place, two line in one. Okay, you can do two line in one, or you can fit a text to a particular place or to a particular width. Okay, you can do character scaling also. You can increase this character to 66, or you can decrease it to 66, because previously it's at 100. You can decrease it to 66, or you can increase it to 200, which is going to increase the sizing or scale it up directly. Or you can do combine characters or combine two line in one. For example, you can select these two lines, and everything is going to be in one line. You can come here, combine two lines in one, and it's going to pop up that you are going to combine this into one line, and you say yes, and you can see everything is now converted into one line as you write accordingly. So these are just some very basic features. You can feel free to go around to continue to try them, to play around with them and see how you can use them. Over here, you have the sorting. You can sort from A to B, 1 to 10. You can do sorting from here, and you can show and hide editing marks in cases when you have when you want to show and hide editing marks. Editing marks actually enable you to know different. You can show editing marks, so you can see the editing marks. They are very small, but you can see them, and you should be able to know that at this point you have this kind of editing, at this point you have this kind of editing, and in between each word you can see the marks. The points are showcasing when you have created a space in between the words, or there's a character in between the words. You should know when you make a mistake of having two spacing between words, you'll be able to know by just the by these signs. Okay, it's very easy to do that. And then you can apply shading from here using this, and you can apply different kind of borders and different kind of border lines. You can see bottom border if you want to add bottom border, or you can add all borders from here if you want to have, or you want to have outside border just like so. By just clicking, you have the outside border, or you can come over here and say all borders, and it's going to create border across the text that you've highlighted. And you can play around with the ruler option over here. Okay, if you need to insert a tab, you can just go ahead and insert a tab from this feature. Okay, so but paragraphing in general, this is just a bit about how to deal with paragraphing and the text editing, also advanced text editing, incorporating paragraphing and all that. In the next class, we're going to look at how to add headers and footers. Okay, how to add headers and footers in WPS. It's very easy, but it's very fantastic as well to learn how to do it. So until next time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.